Poltergeist is German for noisy spirit. Today, parapsychologists use the title recurrent spontaneous psychokinesis, or RSPK, to describe the phenomena. RSPK is usually regarded as surrounding a person, called an agent. RSPK is characterized by movement of objects.
Poltergeist activity is what we call psychokinetic activity.
Objects are thrown around.
Things disappearing and turning up somewhere else.
Buzzing, knocking on the walls, bangings, even to the point of earth-shaking.
Things shooting around the room at colossal speed.
Smells, nasty smells.
This sometimes goes on for weeks, months, very occasionally for years.
It seems to have an intelligence, and that intelligence is destructive, mischievous.
With no intention of harming, and that if anybody is injured, it's an accident.
The phenomena starts off in a small way and builds up over time, much as it does in other areas of parapsychology. If there's the will to do it for whatever reason, you get a sort of feedback where you're creating a ghost, really.
One feature of RSPK is breaking noises. In a number of cases, family members rushed to an area they heard items breaking only to find everything secure. Andre Lange proposed the term telethorby, or a racket produced at a distance, for imitative sounds. An apport is an object that seems to materialize out of thin air and is common in some instances of RSPK.
They said, close the doors, both sides, and we'll see what's happening.
Right, come on then. We're going to settle this once and for all.
Hands on the bench. Fingers touching. Right. Come on then. Throw us a stone.
There was no chance of anybody being in our shop except us three.
Hang on. If we're going to do this as a proper test, well, I think we should be writing everything down.
With that, a pen dropped, and then I started saying things like engine parts.
What about a plug?
We knew then that it wasn't one of us. We were looking at each other. Our hands were still on the bench.
The most common apports are rocks. Stones and other objects falling inside a home is called lithobolia. At times, the objects appear to move in contrast to the law of gravity, falling very slowly. Some are found hot to the touch or completely disappear after they hit something. During the winter of 1981 and 1982, rocks fell on five separate homes on Thornton Road in Birmingham, England. Police were baffled. Local authorities devoted 3,500 man-hours to investigating the phenomenon, but were unable to find a rational explanation.
Thornton Road, Birmingham. It's not the quiet suburban neighborhood, it seems. Five of these houses are under siege. Night after night, rocks rain down on them. The bizarre bombardment has lasted more than 6 years. Glass in every window has been shattered, forcing the residents to erect barricades to protect their homes. The stones seem to come from nowhere, yet the damage they do is real enough. Not just to the buildings, but to the householders' nerves and bank accounts.
We've had all the panes but two go on the garage, which are the big panes. I think they're about 14 foot with reinforced glass, which cost nearly £700 to be replaced. And we have since they've been replaced and the wire netting's been put up. We've had another four panes go now.
Most of the windows on the veranda have been broken. Over £500 worth has been put in there. Various other windows have been cracked. And we have now wired all those windows and have been wired for nearly 12 months.
Birmingham's police confess they're stumped. In charge, Chief Inspector Len Turley.
When I first came here some 12 months ago, I thought at that stage that I would put two policemen on it and it would be finished in a couple of days. That has proven to be totally wrong.
The case has all the hallmarks of a poltergeist outbreak. Its eeriest feature is the way the rocks seem to come out of the blue. In vain, the police have combed the gardens for vandals. No human being seems to be throwing the stones. Yet the stakeout goes on in Thornton Road, night after night.
At this stage, we've probably wasted somewhere in the region of 3,500 man-hours in observations and inquiries in the Thornton Road area. The backs of these four houses in Thornton Road are virtually a battleground.
And clues are hard to come by.
This is a selection of the stones. This one is about average size. As you can see, it is quite a hefty stone. It's a pebble. It looks as if it's come from a seashore, but it hasn't. The gardens of these houses in this area are all have these pebbles in them. The interesting thing about this and all the others that we've had is everyone appears to have been washed or scrubbed. None of them contain any dirt at all. We have had police officers lying, standing, hiding themselves from 6 p.m. in the evening until 2 and 3 o'clock in the morning in all kinds of weather. They have been on top of roofs of adjoining properties. And in all these occasions, the only thing we can say is at certain times, police officers have heard what they say appear to be stones striking the roof or the back of houses. In none of the occasions when we've been doing observations have we seen anybody.
It's as though somebody's watching you, actually going up into a room and drawing the curtains, and you get stones come over as soon as you seem to appear at the window. It's uncanny, really, because it's just as though somebody's focused on you all the time.
I don't really know what's going on down here. This has been going on for a period of 18 months. And we haven't got a clue who's doing it at all.
Already this year, we have arrested 1,997 criminals. We have solved, in the time we have doing this inquiry at Thornton Road, we have recorded and solved 5 murders, 2 of which have been extremely complicated, and the inquiry was very protracted. And we've used the same expertise on our stone throwings as we have on these other incidents, and we're still no farther forward with the stone throwings.
Images of deceased individuals are not common in cases of RSPK. Some parapsychologists call these images pseudo-apparitions. There is some evidence that these ghosts are telepathic projections from the mind of the agent. The phrase interpenetration of matter is used when one solid object seems to pass through another without causing any damage. One of the most startling examples of this phenomena occurred in May 1906 at Furnace Mill, Lamberhurst, Kent, England. Miller J.C. Playfair discovered a horse in the hayloft. The door was only large enough for a man to crawl through. Other instances of RSPK were recorded, including barrels of lime rolling down the stairs in daylight and a heavy barrel of water being overturned. Until the heyday of spiritualism, RSPK was considered the work of demons. With sensational claims of physical manifestations in seance rooms, RSPK was considered by spiritualists to be in the introduction to physical mediumship. Serious investigation by parapsychologists uncovered a very different view on the phenomena. Ed and Lorraine Warren were sensationalists who were involved in some of the most public and speculative poltergeist cases. Their investigations inevitably turned up so-called evidence of demonic activity, when actually the cases are suggestive of RSPK. In 1975, George and Kathy Lutz moved into 112 Ocean Avenue. The home had been the site of familicide by Ronald DeFeo Jr. a year earlier. Claims of paranormal activity as simple as breaking dishes were investigated by Ed and Lorraine Warren, who soon concluded the family was under demonic siege.